religion. So now we will study what kind of religion was followed by Egyptian people. The ancient Egyptians worshipped as many as 2200 gods and goddesses. So they had in total 2200 gods and goddesses, and among them Ra, or the sun god, was the most important. Already have studied in Mesopotamian civilization that sun god was the most important god of Mesopotamian civilization. Similarly, in Egyptian civilization also the sun god was the most important. They called the sun god as Ra. He was considered to be the giver of life and warmth, and they also had gods of moon and floods whom they worshipped. Egyptians worshipped some animals also, like the cow, crocodile, snake, hawk, jackal and bull. So these were the animals that the Mesopotamian people, the Egyptian people worshipped. Each god had his or her own temple and a priest. So every god, they had their own temple, and every god that had their own individual priest or own particular priest. Even the pharaoh, the king, was treated by the people like god. The Egyptians thought that there was life after death. Again, like we studied in Indus Valley civilization, Mesopotamian civilization, that they believed in life after death. Similarly, Egyptian people also believed in life after death. But there is a little bit difference in the belief in the life after death among the Egyptian people. To fulfill their belief, they followed, or they had a very kind of unique procedure, or a very kind of unique phenomena, you can say, they used to follow in order to fulfill their belief in life after death. So what was that procedure? We will study here. They believed that both body and soul lived after death. So according to the Egyptians, they believed that after death both body and the soul lived. So they expected that the dead body of a virtuous man — virtuous means a very good man, a very noble man — if the person was very good and noble, then it was expected that the man could come back to life again. So that is why what they did, they took great care to preserve the dead bodies. They did not bury the dead bodies, but they used to preserve the dead bodies using some kind of very unique chemicals. They used to preserve the dead bodies. Such a preserved dead body is known as mummy. So this kind of preserved dead body is known as mummy. The chemical that was applied to the dead bodies, and then it was wrapped in some kind of white cloth, and then the body was preserved. That was called mummy, and the process was called mummification. The preserved dead body was called mummy, and the process was called mummification. Here is the picture of such kind of mummification body. So this kind of procedure they used to follow. So this was a very unique concept that existed in Egyptian civilization. Now we will study regarding their art, architecture and sculpture. The Egyptians had achieved a very high standard in the fields of art, architecture and sculpture. This can be known from — so the Egyptians, they achieved very high standard in their field of art, architecture and sculpture, and this we can know by studying these three architecture and sculpture that existed in Egypt. What were they? The pyramids, the sphinx and the temples. So we will study about them in details. So first is the pyramids. The Egyptians built pyramids. We can see the picture over here. This is a pyramid, very common structure that we have already seen, that you children might have seen in some of the other book. This is a pyramid. It is a triangular in structure. These were the tombs of the royal family. These pyramids were actually the tombs or the burial places of the royal family. The people who belonged to the royal family, if they died, then they were preserved in these pyramids. Three pyramids at Gizeh are indeed very important. Gizeh is a place in Egypt. Here three pyramids are there. They are very important. The two most spectacular pyramids, or the two most beautiful, very impressive pyramids, are those of pharaohs Khufa and Khafre. These were the two pharaohs, and their pyramids are the most impressive or spectacular pyramids. There are 30 other pyramids and several other small ones also. These are the tombs of the kings, and they contain the mummies of the Egyptian kings. So these pyramids are actually the tombs of the kings. So already you have studied that these pyramids are actually the tombs where the royal family is preserved. So these pyramids are actually the tombs of the kings, and the Egyptian kings, their bodies are mummified and preserved in these pyramid or in these tombs. The walls of the pyramids are decorated with beautiful paintings showing battle scenes, hunting and sacrifices being made. So the walls of the pyramids, they had this kind of paintings to decorate the pyramid. These paintings are also good pieces of art and they tell us about the lifestyle of ancient Egyptians. And then the Sphinx, we will see the picture over here. The Sphinx, that is the head of a man and the body of a lion. This is also a very unique sculpture that existed in Egypt. The Great Sphinx is another astonishing monument in Gizeh near Cairo. It is the structure of a mythological animal. Mythological animal means the animal that is believed to be a myth. Means no one knows that either such kind of animal existed or not. It is a kind of myth, so that is why it is called mythological animal. The Sphinx has the head of a man, as I told you, the head of a man and the body of a lion. That is why it is considered as one of a very unique structure. It is carved out of a single stone. This is a very unique feature of the Sphinx, that it is carved out of one single stone. This entire structure was actually one single stone. It has been carved out and today we see this Sphinx over here. The Great Sphinx at Gizeh is 241 feet long and 65 feet high. The picture we see here, this is the Great Sphinx of Giza. So this is a very famous Sphinx of Egypt and it is the largest sculpture of Egypt also, we can say that. Then the temples, the ancient Egyptians also built temples. There are several of them. Many temples existed in ancient Egypt. Most of them are on or near the river Nile, particularly near Thebes. Thebes is a river. So most of the temples were situated near river Thebes. Outside these temples, there are huge statues of pharaohs and the avenues of sphinxes. So outside these temples, there were statues of pharaohs also. Pharaohs already have studied the kings and avenues of sphinxes also we can see. Now we will see this new word, pyramid. We have already come across this word, an Egyptian stone structure with square base and slanting sides. We will see the picture here, square base and slanting sides. So this is the definition of pyramid. Like the pyramids, the walls of the temples also have beautiful paintings on them. Then the hieroglyphic script of Egypt. This is the script of Egypt, the hieroglyphic script. So the Egyptians also knew the art of writing. Their script is called hieroglyphic script. Like in Mesopotamian civilization, we studied that their script was cuneiform script. In Egyptian civilization, their script was hieroglyphic script, also known as sacred writing. Why it is called sacred writing? Because it was used by the priests only. The hieroglyphic script was used only by the priests. That is why it is called sacred writing. Hieroglyphic script was deciphered by Champollion, who was a great French decipherer. Champollion was a French decipherer. He, decipherer is the person who deciphers this kind of ancient scripts or who reads out this kind of ancient scripts. So this French decipherer Champollion, he deciphered this hieroglyphic script. It was a type of picture writing, again similar to Indus and Mesopotamian civilization. This writing is also a kind of picture writing or pictographic script. You can see here representation of pictures. At first, the Egyptians wrote on stones, walls or clay tablets. So Egyptians, as I have already told you, that time paper did not exist or paper was not discovered. So they used to write on stones, walls or clay tablets. Later on, they made a sort of paper from the reeds and leaves of a tree called papyrus. After that, they came to know of this kind of this tree, that is papyrus, out of whose reed and leaves were used to make this kind of paper. That is why we use the term paper. The paper term has been derived from this word papyrus, because paper was first made from this papyrus tree. Writing in Egypt was a special art. Much of the hieroglyphic writing was done very beautifully and artistically. So in Egypt, hieroglyphic script, writing down of hieroglyphic script was considered to be a very special art, because it required beautiful and artistic skills to be written. And that is why the writers were held in high esteem, means high respect in society and by the kings. Anybody who used to write this hieroglyphic script, they were highly respected in the society. Not only in the society, they were highly respected by the kings also. Then contributions of the Egyptian civilization. The Egyptians made significant contribution to the growth of knowledge, similar to Mesopotamian civilization. Egyptian civilization also made contribution in knowledge. They developed the solar calendar, which was more accurate than the lunar calendar. Solar calendar is actually the calendar that was made according to the readings or the position of the sun, and which was more accurate. Accurate means correct or exact in comparison to lunar calendar given by the Babylonians. So these Babylonians, these were a group of people in Babylonia. So they gave this lunar calendar. Lunar calendar is the calendar made according to the position of the moon. So Babylonians made this lunar calendar, but the solar calendar developed by the Egyptian civilization, that was far more accurate in comparison to the lunar calendar. In order to make pyramids, they made a good use of arithmetic and geometry. So it is not like that the pyramids were made only like that. It was in order to make pyramids, arithmetic and geometry was used. So from this we come to know that they had good knowledge in arithmetic and geometry also. They gave the world the measurements of triangle and rectangle. They also developed the decimal system of counting and used special signs to represent units, tens, hundreds, thousands and so on. So they used this decimal system of writing, and for representing this units, tens, hundreds, thousands, place value that we study in maths. So that kind of place value was represented using different signs. They knew about chemicals that could preserve the bodies of the dead. Already we have studied in the process of mummification that they used very good chemicals to preserve these dead bodies. So from this we come to know that they had the knowledge of using chemicals also in order to preserve the dead bodies. Now we will study the Wang Hu civilization, which is also known as the Chinese civilization. And why it is called Wang Hu civilization, we will study now. Located in East Asia, China witnessed the rise of the great civilization nearly 4500 years ago. The Chinese civilization is also a river valley civilization like the other three civilizations. So we have already studied Indus Valley civilization, Mesopotamian civilization and the Egyptian civilization. They were all river valley civilizations. Similarly, Chinese civilization is also a river valley civilization. The civilization flourished in the river basin of three main rivers. River basin is the area or the surrounding in which the river flows. So this Chinese civilization is situated in the river basin of not one or two rivers, but three main rivers. What were they? The Wang Hu in the north, the Yangtze Kiang in the center, and the Sikiang in the south. So this Chinese civilization is drained by these three rivers, Wang Hu, Yangtze Kiang and Sikiang. And that is why Chinese civilization is also another river valley civilization. Fertile land and temperate climate. Temperate is moderate climate, neither very hot nor very cold. Temperate climate made this valley an ideal place for settlement. So since this civilization or this particular place, China, is drained by three rivers, so obviously the soil is very fertile and the climate is also temperate, moderate over there. So these are the conditions which make this place highly suitable for settlement. Chinese civilization developed during the Shang dynasty. This was the empire or the dynasty that ruled the Chinese civilization, was the Shang dynasty, during which Chinese civilization developed. So we will study the people and the society. The society in China was divided into classes. The emperor or the king and his family held the top position. So the first class comprises of the king and his family. Then the second class comprises the nobles, scholars, merchants, artisans, craftsmen and the cultivators from the other classes below the ruling family. And the lowermost class were the slaves. They led a very miserable life. The slaves, they were treated very badly, very harshly. They led a very miserable life. They were sometimes buried alive along with the masters. The slaves had such a poor condition that even sometimes when the masters of the slave died, the slaves also, they were buried alive along with their dead masters so that they could serve him even after the latter's death. Latter means after the king's death. After the master's death. So after the it was believed that this particular slave will serve his master even when he comes alive after his death. So that is why the slaves were buried alive in the grave of their masters.
The soldiers were a class apart. The soldiers, they were a very, they belong to a very different class. They belong to a very different society. They are not included in these three classes, but they belong to a very different society. They were held in high esteem. They were very respected in the society. People were even afraid of the soldiers. This shows that defense was given high importance in the Chinese civilization. The soldiers were, the people were very much afraid of the soldiers. So from this we come to know that defense was highly important in Chinese civilization. Then occupations and crafts. Agriculture was the main occupation of the Chinese people. Agriculture was helped greatly due to the existence of lois. Agriculture was highly developed because of the existence of lois. What is this lois? It is very important. A very fine and exceptionally fertile soil carried by the rivers through the central plain. So this lois is a very fine, very fertile soil that was carried down by the rivers through the central plains of China, making it one of the finest lands for agriculture in the world. That is why agriculture was the main occupation in Chinese civilization. In some less fertile areas, they used manure to increase productivity of crops, and the areas which were less fertile, in those areas they used manure or fertilizers to increase the crop production. They had an excellent canal system to control floods. So to control flood, they had this canal system. Already we have studied in Mesopotamian civilization also that in Egyptian civilization also that canals, dikes and reservoirs were built in order to prevent the flooding of river Nile. So similarly, the Chinese also had this excellent canal system to control flood. And the crops that were grown were wheat, rice, millet, soybean and tea. There were other occupations also apart from agriculture. They were carpentry and woodwork were the other occupations. Chinese carpenters were famous for cabinet making. Cabinet are the small structures, means small cupboards like structures. Then timber work in palaces, means wooden work in palaces, ivory work on wood, etc. Bronze casting became a large scale business under the Shang dynasty. Bronze casting is the use of bronze in making some kind of statues or sculptures. That is bronze casting. It was very much used in Shang dynasty. Chinese bronzes were the product of an advanced technology, very advanced technology, very advanced science was used for production of bronze in China. There was another important industry in China was the silk industry. Silk production and silk industry was also an occupation of Chinese people. They bred silkworms. They bred with silkworms means they used to cultivate or they used to keep these silkworms and made silk out of the cocoons. Cocoons of the silk they used to make, cocoons of the silkworm they used to make silk. China became the world center of silk production. They exported silk to other countries through silk routes. Silk route was actually the way or the path through which this silk was exported to other countries. And that is why, since silk was exported through that path came to be known as silk routes. As the Chinese developed paper, the making of paper became another important occupation of the people during this period. Now we will study the architecture that existed in China. The Chinese had developed